Welcome back to Studio 10, everybody. Like so many, Mariska Breland began Pilates as a way to battle her fear of slowing metabolism. But when she was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, her dedication to her craft became even more intense.
And she began teaching mat Pilates at an existing studio as a means to get free yoga classes. But her innovative, more fast-paced classes gained a serious following, and soon Fuse Pilates was born. And she's going to teach us the ins and outs and tips and tricks of Fuse Pilates. And it's kind of a different sort of an approach to Pilates, right?
Correct. So we always teach to music, and we always teach on request. So you might come into one class and it'll be completely different from another class you take because the requests have been different. And we try to hit beats to the music, so it's a little bit more fun, a little bit more dance-like. It's unfortunately not easier.
Oh, so man, because regular Pilates is really hard,
but
and I think I should have stretched.
You're going to have to not only do Pilates, but get your groove on.
I know. It's even harder. Oh, yeah. It's so difficult. But really, if you are starting Pilates, say, for the first time, what are some tips, some good tips for people?
I mean, I think just first be really gentle on yourself, you know, not to have such high expectations that you can necessarily do everything right away.
Don't try to get it all the first time, right?
No, and don't worry about it if you can't get it all the first time. I don't think, you know, any good teacher's ever going to judge you if you can't do everything perfectly, because I guarantee that no teacher can do everything perfectly either.
But if it doesn't hurt, you're not doing it right, right?
That's not true.
Well, there is a difference between feel the burn pain, which is excellent, and you want to go for that.
Feel the burn.
And anything stabbing, searing, pinching, like that kind of pain, you don't want.
Convulsing, none of that.
Convulsing.
Okay, you should stop at that point.
Anything like that, you want to stop.
Okay.
Hey, we mentioned, Mariska, that you were diagnosed with MS shortly after you started doing Pilates.
Correct.
And talk a little bit about the neuromuscular sort of component, I guess, of Pilates. I mean, this has really been good for you.
Absolutely. And I think, like, what's really interesting is anything you have going on in your life, whether it's, you know, you have something as serious as multiple sclerosis or you have something just, you know, as mild as tension headaches, I think that Pilates can help. Because you learn to become very connected with your body and really understand, you know, you move this muscle first and then you move this muscle, and just really getting that sense of, like, the best way to move. And then learning to move from your core, you know, is great. And obviously, you know, as we all start to get older, things start to fall down.
They sure do.
That didn't fall down when we were younger.
And we can lift them back up.
Exactly.
In a nutshell, multiple sclerosis is, it's a breakdown in communication between the brain and the spinal cord?
It's a breakdown in communication between the brain and the nerves.
The nerves,
generally.
Okay.
So
all right.
What happens is, if you think about your brain and spinal cord having a level of insulation on them, you start to get little holes in the insulation, and so the message gets a little stuttered. And depending on how much the damage is, sometimes it gets a lot stuttered.
I was going to say, and you have multiple sclerosis, and you're getting treated for it, obviously.
Yeah, I have, you know, I have a neurologist, I have my teams and physical therapists and everybody.
What was your first warning sign that you had, or your first indication?
Well, you know, I had numb feet for like 6 months and didn't actually think much of it because I was always somebody who worked out a lot. So I thought, you know, probably pinched a nerve. So I think that everybody always blames stuff on, like, it's a pinched nerve. So, and then actually the day I moved to D.C., I had double vision. Like, I was seeing two of everything when I looked to the left, and I hadn't been drinking, so I knew that that was, like, probably, like, a significant problem.
That's not a good sign.
So then I went to a neurologist who sent me to a neuro-ophthalmologist, and then I had an MRI, and that's how it was diagnosed. But I'd had, looking back, I mean, I had symptoms for years. You know, I'd have, like, things would go numb, or I'd have weird kind of pins and needles.
Just out of nowhere?
Feeling. Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
And it would come and go, which is actually very common with the type of MS I have.
Well, let's work out.
Let's
do some moves here.
Show us some
moves. Okay, so I understand, Jerome, you wanted to work on, you know, your tush, right?
It needs a lot of work.
We're gonna do two different exercises. First, let's go ahead and lay down on your back.
That's no problem.
I know it's the best part of any exercise.
It's the trouble with the show. We never get a chance to lay down.
Okay, so we're gonna lay down.
Take our shoes off for that matter.
No shoes.
Okay.
Reach your arms long by your side and bend your knees.
Okay.
So I'm going to keep my bend your knees, feet flat to the floor.
Okay.
Let's go ahead and bring your right leg up. So your knee is over your hip.
All right.
And then just press into your left foot. Try to keep your hips square and peel your back away from the mat.
Okay.
So do you feel anything in the back of your body working?
Oh, my God, yes.
Okay, then we're going to slowly lower down all the way down to the floor. So try to go one vertebra at a time down, and then let your tailbone find the floor. So you get to go all the way down.
Okay.
You get to lower down.
Are we done?
Jerome, you're going to feel this in your hamstring.
So we're going to go ahead and lift it back up. Oh, we have some music. So now we can come to the top. If you want to make it harder, you send your leg up. If you want to make it harder, if you want to make it harder, you lower your leg down to 45 degrees. From there, we're going to do little hip lifts. Up an inch, okay. Down an inch. Up, down.
This is a first for this show, for
down,
sure.
Up and down. So think about that inch being the inch that you mean when you go to get a haircut, not the inch that you get. So it's really small.
This is amazing what a workout this is.
And down. So we, you know, we'd repeat that for a little while. Let's go ahead and bend your knees so we can do something a little bit different.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Just rock yourself up to seated.
Oh, all right.
And then we're gonna come onto your side.
Okay.
So we're gonna face this way. Let's just drop down to your forearm. Bend your knees like you're sitting in a chair. And then push the floor away. So you don't wanna kind of relax into your shoulders. So you lift it up. Bring the opposite hand on your hip or somewhere. Lift your top leg up hip height. And then we're gonna move from the hip. Touch your knee together, then ankle. Knee and ankle.
Is this good for your butt?
This is really meant for that that outer part of your butt. So that's the part that lifts. So the other part that we worked was from where your butt and your thigh come together. We've affectionately named that the bathigh area. It's not an anatomical name.
You came up with
hey,
that.
By the way,
but everyone understands what it is.
We're running out of time, but we want to tell you that if you do want to participate in one of Mariska's classes, there are still some spots available at a class tonight at 6 o'clock at Yogani Studio in Tampa. So we'll put the number on our Facebook page after the show today.
Hanging
and if
in
you
there?
Want to be one of the folks to participate, then you can call. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Mariska. Obviously, during the commercial break, we'll do the other side.
Right. Because we cannot be lopsided. When we come back, we're going to tell you how eating a PDQ can help Bay Area families. This is burning.
We do this during every commercial
children
break.
Children are battling cancer. Don't go away. We'll be right back after this. I am sweating.